Tired of watching your plans dissolve whenever your friends get new cards before you do? Make sure your fate is foretold this set release by pre-ordering Born of the Gods product from ChannelFireball.com. You can pre-order singles, boosters, sealed boxes, fat packs, or special combos from us, and we'll ship them when the set releases on February 7th. You don't have to be an Omen speaker to know that pre-ordering from Channel Fireball is a great idea.
Hello and welcome. My name is Caleb Deward, recording here for ChannelFireball.com, and this is a Esper Tezzeret control deck for Modern. I've been very excited about this deck. It was one of the winners for the Modern deck brewing contest that I did about a month ago, I think. And I already ran it through a set of dailies, and I usually don't revisit decks, but afterwards I was really unhappy with the sideboard, and I knew that it needed work and some tweaks in some locations. So I did that. I came back to it, mostly because the deck's like a lot of fun, and it gave me an excuse to meddle with it on Modo and tune the deck better, because, I mean, building and tuning decks is really what I enjoy about Magic, way more so than, like, actually playing tournaments or grinding. But, like, making changes and then seeing it, how it impacts the actual games is just one of the most fun things you can do, I think. Anyway, I made a few tweaks. I added another basic to the mana base, which is nice, because sometimes if you're playing a control opponent and they path your creatures or your man lands or whatever, you can actually run out of basics, and then if they're like also using removal spell and tech edges on you, that can actually matter. You can like run out of lands and be strapped at a point when you need to like Gifts Ungiven plus on burial rites in a turn, and when you should be able to do that, you don't, because you don't have anything to fetch out. So Misty Grain Forest was really underperforming for me, so I cut it for another Plains. I've been really happy with that switch. It also means that my draws are less painful. Instead of having to crack my Misty and get a Hollowed Fountain and take three, I just have a Plains. I can just be like, yep, have a Plains. So I like draws with lots of basics, especially since there's so much fixing in this deck, artifact fixing. I also added the Talisman of Dominance. Since Misty Rainforest could fetch a black source, the talisman gives me that source, and then it also reduces the number of mulligans that I have to take. If you have an opener without like a talisman, a spellskite, or a path to exile, you almost always have to mulligan it, just because like a turn 3 Thirst for Knowledge is not going to win you the game in Modern. You really need to be able to compete, and that involves a turn 3 Supreme Verdict or a turn 3 Gifts Ungiven for Unveil Your Rights. The only time a turn 3 Tezzeret is good is when you're playing against a control or combo deck when you actually just need to kill them. And that's what Tezzeret's really good at. It's not here to like grind the opponent out with card advantage. Sometimes it does that, and it almost feels like an accident, and you're kind of like, really? I won because I drew a couple cards off this Tezzeret? That doesn't make sense. It's really just here to be like, yeah, I've got an indestructible Darksteel Citadel beating you down, or I have an Ink Moth Nexus that kills you in two turns. The two-turn clock is pretty awesome out of a control deck in this format. It's really, really unlikely. And the Gifts Ungiven package is kind of a kill-you function, too. It's like Gifts Ungiven, Unburial Rites, Elesh Norn win the game against just a huge swath of the field. And then post-board, when they bring in their either their Artifact Hate for your Tezzeret package or their Graveyard Hate for your Gifts Ungiven package, you can just do the other one. They're like Stony Silence, and you're like, alright, I guess I'm not tapping my Signet. Gifts for Elesh Norn. Or they're like Rest in Peace, and then you're like, alright, I'll Gifts for, I don't know, Thirst, Attention Sphere, Wormcoil Tez, whatever it is that will just be a value Gifts package. Gifts for Gifts, why not? When I do Gifts and the opponent has a Rest in Peace in play, so I can't use Unburial Rites, I actually tend to get a value package without the win conditions. Because if they put the win conditions in your graveyard, that's stripping your deck of your threats. So Gifts for like Thirst for Knowledge, Gifts Ungiven, and some removal spells is usually better, because then you're thinning your deck of cards that... Oh, I got a match going. I'll finish talking up really quick. Let's see, where was I? Yeah, you never want to thin your deck of win conditions. You gotta be able to top deck those and win. What else? Oh, I shaved a Wrath of God for the third Supreme Verdict. I've been pretty happy with that. Wrath is nice when you're affinity opponent is playing Welding Jar, but like most of those guys, you're just beating with Elishnorn. That's like, it just wins. So that's just such a good matchup. Whereas like the Delver tempo-y matchups with a pile of counter magic are worse. So that's why the main reason that I'm playing more Supreme Verdicts now. Although one downside to Supreme Verdict is that the mana is tougher. So there is that. There are a lot of colorless sources in the deck. There's a lot of colored sources as well. There's a ton of colored mana, but you can't have draws that are full of colorless sources every once in a while. Not very often. The mana is surprisingly good. The main changes I made were to the sideboard. The only cards that I kept were the four Negate. Negate's just such a good card in Modern. I've main decked it before, been really happy with it. I wouldn't main deck it in this deck. It's kind of a tap out style deck. You want to be able to play your Wurmcoil Engines on turn 5 or whatever after you sweep the board. But post-board, when you can bring in a pile of negates, that's just awesome. So I ended up cutting a lot of specific cards, cards that hate on specific strategies, like he had Ghostly Prisons and that sort of thing, for more general answers, like discard. And this way, against combo or control, I can have a gifts package for like Thoughtseize Inquisition, Duress, Negate, and actually just like untap and disrupt them, get information on their hand, that sort of thing. I've been really happy with the discard. And one thing I was having trouble with against Jund was just dealing with a Dark Confident. Yes, the deck has so many sweepers, but just killing a Dark Confident was hard to do because, I mean, it comes down on turn two. If you're on the draw, you untap, you like play your talisman or something, or maybe you don't, and then they untap and they draw a pile of cards and they shred your hand, and then you untap and like maybe you have a wrath effect, maybe you don't at this point. And this is just so nice, just to be able to kill it, and then it gives you another tutor package for Gifts Ungiven, in some matchups where that matters. I'm not sure about the Smother; it's been weaker than Go for the Throat and Path by quite a lot, so that might become a Doomblade, even though Doomblade doesn't kill Bob. Yeah, it doesn't make sense. Maybe Dismember. Maybe Dismember would be fine. And then the Leyline of Sanctities are mostly because the Burn is a bad matchup. And I've lost to it a few times on Moto. Anyway, got a match to get to.